Hi all, today I am discussing about the topic is flagella. How are 4 marks important question? How are bacteria are classified on the basis of flagella? Flagella, bacterial cells are endowed with flagella. Due to the presence of flagella, it involves motility or movement from one place to another place. Depending upon the number of flagella, bacterium cells are divided into 5 types. First one is atrichous bacteria. Atrichous means the bacteria cell without flagella is called atrichous. Mono means single. A single flagella present at one end of the bacterium cell is called monotrichous. Next, third one is lophotrichous. Two or many flagella present at one end of the bacterium cell is called lophotrichous. And fourth one is amphitrichous. One or many flagella present at both ends of the bacterium cell is called amphitrichous. And last one, peritrichous. Peritrichous means flagella distributed all over the surface of the bacterium cell. Is called peritrichous. And next topic is plasmids. Genophore means the bacterial cell. Bacterial cell contain a main genetic material. It is a double helical structure. The main genetic material of the bacterial cell is called genophore or bacterial chromosome. The main genetic material of the bacterium cell is called genophore or bacterial chromosome or nucleoid. It is the main genetic material. Along with the main genetic material, bacterium cell also contain a small circular double-stranded DNA. It is called plasmid. It is the extra genomic material present in the bacterium cell. Along with the main genetic material, genophore or bacterial chromosome or nuclei, this is called plasmid. Plasmid contain resistance to drugs. It contain resistance to drugs, and also involves the production of enzymes. Plasmids are easily isolated from the bacterium cell and easily reintroduced into the bacterium cell. Next, nowadays plasmids are used as vectors in modern genetic engineering technique. These are the plasmids. 2 marks big. What is plasmid and what is its significance? Plasmid means the main genetic material of the bacterium cell is called genophore. Along with the genophore, bacterium cell also contain a small circular double-stranded DNA. The small circular double-stranded DNA in the bacterium cell is called plasmid, and it contain resistance to drugs, and it also involves the production of enzymes. Next, plasmids are easily isolated from the bacterium cell and easily reintroduced into the bacterium cell. Nowadays, plasmids are used as vectors in modern genetic engineering technique. Next, nutrition. Bacterial nutrition. Another 4 marks important question. How are bacteria are classified on the basis of energy and carbon source? How are bacteria are classified on the basis of energy and carbon source? Based on the energy source and carbon source, bacterial nutrition is divided into 4 types. First one is photoautotrophs. And second one is chemoautotrophs. Third one, photoheterotrophs. And fourth one, chemoheterotrophs. Based on energy source and carbon source, bacterial nutrition is divided into 4 types. First one is photoautotrophs. Photo means light, sunlight. Autotrophs means they obtain food from first energy. They obtain energy from the sunlight. These bacteria obtain energy from sunlight and carbon from atmospheric carbon dioxide. Hence, these type of bacteria are called photoautotrophs. Photoautotrophs are the bacteria, they obtain energy from sunlight and carbon from atmospheric carbon dioxide. They capture light energy and converts into chemical energy. These type of bacteria are called, also called as photoautotrophs. Examples, chromatium and chlorobium. Chromatium and chlorobium. These bacteria are called as photoautotrophs. Second one, chemoautotrophs. Second type of bacteria are called chemoautotrophs. They obtain energy from the oxidation of inorganic substances. Energy from the oxidation of inorganic substances and carbon from atmospheric carbon dioxide. These type of bacteria are called as chemoautotrophs. These bacteria obtain energy from the oxidation of inorganic substances and carbon from the atmospheric carbon dioxide. These bacteria are called chemoautotrophs. Example, Nitrosomonas, Nitrobacter, Bagiota, and Methanogens. Bagiota and Methanogens. These are the chemoautotrophs. Next, third type of bacteria are called photoheterotrophs. Photo means sunlight. They obtain energy from the sunlight and carbon from the oxidation of organic substances. These are called photo heterotrophs. Third type of bacteriums obtain energy from light or sunlight, and carbon from the oxidation of organic substances. Such type of bacteriums are called as photoheterotrophs. Example, Rhodospirillum. Rhodospirillum and Rhodopseudomonas. These are the photoheterotrophs. And the last one is chemoheterotrophs. These bacteriums obtain both energy and carbon from the oxidation of organic substances. Fourth type of bacteriums obtain energy and carbon. Both energy and carbon from the oxidation of organic substances. Such type of bacteriums are called as chemoheterotrophs. Again, chemoheterotrophs divided into two types. First one is saprophytes. And second one is parasites. First one, saprophytes. Saprophytes means they obtain food from the dead organisms. They obtain food from dead organisms. These are called saprophytes. Example, Bacillus species. Some Bacillus species are saprophytes. Next, parasites. They obtain food from the living cells and tissues of the host. Example, Xanthomonas and Salmonella. These are the parasites. They obtain food from living cells and tissues of the host organisms. Example, Xanthomonas and Salmonella.